Hi, and welcome to yet another new episode of VersaVlog. In this vlog, I will going to talk about Operations Management Suite, Log Analytics, and Security Center, especially those workloads combined. I will give you 10 tips on how to get the most out of these workloads. So let's start with tip number one. Always have one and only one Operations Management Suite workspace per subscription. Security Center makes use of the Operations Management Suite workspace, and it's only able to have one workspace per subscription. So only use one workspace per subscription. Tip number two. If you already have an Operations Management Suite workspace and you want to get started with a Security Center, nowadays you are able to select an existing Operations Management Suite workspace. Back in the early days, that was not possible, and Security Center always created its own workspace. If you don't have an Operations Management Suite workspace running and you want to get started with Security Center, first create the Operations Management Suite workspace. You can put it in the resource group you like, give it the name you like, and later hook Security Center on it. Tip number three. Security Center is able to install an agent that's required for monitoring on your virtual machines. It's able to install it automatically. Once it detects that there is a new virtual machine in your Azure subscription, it will automatically install this agent on your virtual machine. This tip will save you lots of time of manual provisioning your virtual machines with the Operations Management Suite agent that's required for Security Center. Tip number four. If you happen to have multiple Operations Management Suite workspaces, try to install the Operations Management Suite solutions in the workspace that's also used for Security Center. Try to make that Operations Management Suite workspace your primary workspace from where you will monitor all your Azure resources. My next tip is about Operations Management Suite. You have it in multiple offerings, the free version and the paid versions. With the free version, it only collects up to 500 megabytes of data for a day. Create an alert that will notify you when you hit that 500 megabyte limit. You then know that you have to upgrade to a paid version of Operations Management Suite. Tip number six, learn Gusto. Operations Management Suite logs all its data in databases. You can query these data via a query language. That query language is called Gusto. Learn it, it's very powerful. With Gusto, you're able to query over multiple Operations Management Suite workspaces. If you happen to have multiple Azure subscriptions, within each subscription Operations Management Suite workspace deployed, you can query over all those workspaces with Gusto. My next tip is about alerting. What I see at lots of my customers is that they have an Operations Management Suite workspace deployed and have a couple of solutions in it, and they watch that solutions often, but they don't have alerts set up. You can easily set up alerts, so when something happened in your environment or a certain log is logged into the Operations Management Suite workspace, you will get notified about it. My next tip is actually not about Security Center, not about Operations Management Suite, but a related subject, Logic Apps. You can use Logic Apps to handle alerts that are generated by Security Center and Operations Management Suite. By default, alerts can trigger a webhook, a runbook, they can send you an email or maybe an SMS. But with Logic Apps, you can use a lot more of output connectors. Try and use Logic Apps for handling your Operations Management Suite alerts. And my last tip is about Power BI. Enable Power BI for both Security Center and Operations Management Suite. With Power BI, you are able to report over a longer time on your environment. When something happened in your environment, you will get an alert. But you might want to see how the application is secure and performing over time. You can do that by hooking Power BI up to your Security Center and Operations Management Suite workspace. You can have reports in there that will report over a period of time. And that are my tips for this Azure vlog. If you like this one, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to this channel, and see you at another episode in 2 weeks. See ya!